Seatbelts, everyone!
Please let this be a normal field trip.
With a friend? No way!
Cruising on down Main Street, you're relaxed and feeling good. Next thing that you know, you'll see it.
Octopus in my neighborhood.
Surfing on a sound wave, swinging through the stars.
Yeah.
Take a left at your intestine, take your second right past Mars.
On the magic school bus.
Navigate a nostril.
Climb on the magic school bus.
Make a plane turn to.
Take that.
On our magic school bus.
Rock the river of lava.
On the magic school bus.
Such a fine thing to do. So strap your bones right to the seat. Come on in and don't be shy.
Come on.
Just to make your day complete. You might get baked into a pie
on the magic school bus.
Step inside, it's a wilder ride. Come on.
Ride on the magic school bus.
Okay, guys. I'll show you how to do it. Stand back.
Way to go, Wanda!
All right! Good jump! But I'm only halfway to the basket! I'll never jump high enough to do a slam dunk!
At least you jumped higher than I did. And I've been pumping iron to build up my muscles!
Lifting weights isn't going to get you there, Carlos. There's no way any of us can do a slam dunk. We're too short.
DA's right. Basketball players are way taller than we are, which means we have to jump higher to cover the same distance.
Too bad the slam dunk exhibition isn't in 10 years to give us time to grow up.
I don't see what you're all so worried about. Only one kid from the whole school is going to get picked for the exhibition. What are the chances it'll be one of us?
Attention, please. This is your principal speaking.
Hey, listen up. It's Mr. Rule.
The drawing has been completed for the student who will represent our school in the slam dunk exhibition at tonight's game.
Oh, please, let it be me.
And the winner is, from Miss Frizzle's class, Phoebe Therese.
Oh, no. Me? You can do it, Phoebe.
Yeah, you can do it. Can't you?
But I can't jump. I'm only good at games where you stay on the ground.
It's okay, Phoebs. We'll help you.
Yeah, come on. Isn't jumping just using your muscles to push your weight up off the ground? You're right. This is just a battle between me and gravity. To jump higher, all I have to do is throw myself into the air as hard as I can. It didn't work.
Well, the good news is you went up.
But then you came back down. Just like this ball.
According to my research, it's gravity that makes things fall by pulling down on them.
So, the problem is, no matter what, gravity is always going to pull down on me.
Too true, Phoebe. Gravity may be invisible, but make no mistake, it's always there, and it's always pulling on you. What goes up must come down.
Miss Frizzle!
Whew! That's the problem, all right. So how can Phoebe jump high enough to do a slam dunk before she gets pulled down by gravity again?
An uplifting question, Tim.
If my problem is gravity, then what I need to do is get rid of gravity. No pull, no problem.
Get rid of gravity? What planet do you live on?
Well, maybe not get rid of all gravity, but get rid of some of it.
Get real, Phoebe. To get less gravity, you'd have to go to the moon.
Now there's a weighty notion.
Oh.
But we don't have time to go to the moon.
Did I say we were going to the moon, Arnold?
No, but...
Come along, class, to the bus. You too, Liz.
If we're not going to the moon, then where are we going?
I have to do my slam dunk in just a few hours. If only I could just do it once, just to see what it feels like.